So I set up Taboon Kitchen in Soho in London around exactly a year ago from now. And the plan was very much to build a model that's scalable and replicable so we can build a brand not only in the UK but internationally and eventually through franchising. So a taboon means a bread, Palestinian bread, and the oven. And I wanted something to reflect my heritage. My mother's from Jerusalem, my father's from Bethlehem. So I wanted Jerusalem home cooking and family recipes that I grew up with. And the target market is very much the British and European customers and guests. As an entrepreneur, the funding for my endeavor has been very tough at the beginning because always with a startup, it's not easy to invest in a concept that hasn't been proven yet. So it has been mainly with people I know, very very successful female entrepreneurs actually, who believed in the concept and what we're doing, and they have seen my track record with other businesses, as well as film production, and they invested, as well as getting leverage with loans and funding and so on. So the plan was, get the proof of concept first and then go for more professional funding to be able to roll out very soon. Gazelle Advisory Group can be very, very helpful with the fundraising for Taboon Kitchen for a rollout. And I think it's very important for us that you have the Middle Eastern and Western background and sensibility with your contacts and relationships with family offices. I think you can bridge directly the gap to fundraising for Taboon, including it could be a mixture of EIS investors or Tier 1 visas or just family offices who are interested in investing in a UK brand. Because we're very much about building IP and creating IP for a brand that can grow. So the blueprint for Taboon Kitchen is very much to have a rollout early next year. So we're going to complete the fundraise for Soho now before in the next 4 weeks. And then soon after, we're going to look at the fundraise to roll out to other restaurants in London, probably in Shoreditch and areas like Soho where you have high footfall of businesses as well as local residents and very vibrant areas. So it's very much to have three stores and sites by next year and with a plan to look at the franchising model soon after. As an Arab woman, as an entrepreneur, as a Palestinian, it's never easy really to start a business. I think you're not taken as seriously as you'd like to, but I think the proof is in the pudding. As I built successful businesses, one of them I've exited in my hair care range and toiletries, I developed a brand that sold in Tesco, Boots and all the multiples, and it did extremely well, so we exited. Then I did film production and then moved now to restaurants. But they're all in the creative sector, they're all in the IP creation, they're all scalable and businesses that can be replicated and grown. So I think as an Arab woman, you don't get the support that you would like to, but I think meeting the right people and building the network of people who have the same vision and who share the values and where I'm trying to go to is always very helpful. So someone like yourself as a Gazelle would be very helpful as Gazelle Advisory to help us raise the funds and to reach our goal. Thank you for inviting me, Gazelle Advisory, here to the conference. I think my aim is I'd love to share more because there aren't many female Arab entrepreneurs, so I'd like to sort of be one of the voices of Arab women in business. Also, I'd love to be able to meet potential either investors or to network with people who could bridge that gap and help me achieve the vision that I want to for Taboon and other businesses that I'm doing.